Today we are going to learn a poem, Fire and Ice, written by Robert Frost. Some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. From what I have tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. But if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction, ice is also great and would suffice. Fire and Ice is a symbolic poem by Robert Frost. The poet wants to aware the humanity that everything will end one day as a result of human misdeeds. The poet says that both fire and ice are destructive. Fire of violent desires will put the world to an end. The poet feels that this world of ours will come to an end. He is not very clear when the end will come. He moves to this conclusion on the basis of what people say on this subject. He seems to show his agreement at what people say regarding the ending of the world. The poet believes that this world will come to an end by the two highly contrasting but powerful elements of nature, that is, fire and ice. Either fire or ice will be the cause of the ending of the world. The poet links these two powerful elements to human beings and their emotions. He agrees with those who believe that fire will cause the end of the world. He links the element of fire to the human emotion of desire or passions. The uncontrolled fire of passion and desire may lead us to the end of this world. Next, the poet talks about the second alternative that will destroy the world. What is the second alternative the poet has talked here is ice. It too brings end to the world. In terms of human emotion, ice means hate created by cold reasoning. The poet himself has experienced both these primal emotions of love as well as hate. Fire as well as ice, passions as well as cold reason. He has experienced enough of hate which is born out of icy cold reasoning. In the end, Frost agrees that it doesn't matter whether it is fire or ice, or both can cause the end of the world. Ice or hate born out of cold reasoning is quite sufficient to destruct the world. Next, let us see what are the literary devices the poet has employed in this poem. First, it is rhyming scheme. What's a rhyming scheme is used in the poem? It is ABA, ABC and BCB. Next, figure of speech. It is assonance. What is assonance? It is the repetition of vowel sounds in same line. The long vowel sound O is repeated in the poem. I hold with those who favor fire. So in this line, hold those favor. The long O vowel sound is repeated. Next, imagery. What is imagery? Imagery is just perceiving things involving five senses. In the lines, some say the world will end in fire to say that for destruction, ice is also great. The poet has used imagery in these two lines. Next, anaphora. What do you mean by anaphora? It is a repetition of a word or expression at the start of two or more consecutive lines. In the first and second line of the poem, the word some say is repeated. So it is anaphora. Next it is personification. As you all very well know that, what is personification? It is nothing but just giving the human quality to inanimate object. What are the objects the poet has personified here? It is ice and fire. Ice and fire, these two are capable of destruction. But this ice and fire, they personify by the poet has personified by giving them mind and power to destroy something. Next it is enchantment. What is enchantment? It is defined as the clause that does not come to an end at a line break, rather it moves over to the next line. So in the following lines, the enchantment is being followed by the poet. From what I have tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor fire. There is no break in between these two lines. So the poet has used enchantment in these two lines. I hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you.